I'm Eddie Wilde, and I manage the maths team at the OCR exam board. Here at OCR, we're developing a new GCSE in response to government guidelines to help the next generation become more nimble with numbers and adept with data. Although you won't be teaching the new courses until September 2015, the new specifications will be coming to you in autumn 2014, so you'll have time to familiarise yourself with them. This video is to acquaint you with the main changes and get you started in your thinking. You'll be relieved to hear that there are a few things that stay the same. There'll still be a foundation tier and a higher tier, and much of the content will be familiar. As for the changes, we've grouped them under six headings. Firstly, the new maths GCSE is much bigger. In fact, some suggest it's up to twice the size of some other GCSEs. There'll be much more content for students to learn. At foundation tier, to take one example, students will now need to understand how to factorise quadratics and represent vectors with diagrams. All of this additional content will mean, of course, more time in the classroom, perhaps up to 20% more teaching time each week. You also need to be aware that the new maths GCSE will be double weighted in the new school performance measures. Secondly, quite a bit of the content is changing. The new maths GCSE is more demanding. There'll be less emphasis on rote learning and more on problem solving, where students have to use techniques to solve problems using and designing models as appropriate. Some questions will be less clearly structured and be more open-ended and set within a real-world context. Students have to work across different strands of maths to come up with solutions. All students will need to master fundamentals like calculation, ratio, and proportion, but it adds a higher level of mathematical thinking for all and is designed to challenge the most able. Thirdly, there will still be three assessment objectives, but there are some significant changes to them. AO1 is still about recalling and applying standard techniques. What's new is that students will have to tackle multi-step problems, and not just single-step ones, common in some current exam papers. Basically, students will no longer be guided through each stage of a problem. AO2 is very different. It's now about reasoning, interpreting, drawing conclusions, and constructing chains of reasoning. Quite a significant difference from applying mathematics in context or selecting appropriate methods. AO3 is still about problem solving, but now requires students to make connections between different strands of maths and also to evaluate their methods. It's important to be aware that the problem solving in AO3 is quite a bit more important than before in both tiers. We reckon it will account for at least 25% of the new GCSE. Fourthly, the structure of the qualification is changing. The new GCSE is truly linear, so you'll need to make an adjustment in how you teach. So, instead of a modular approach, what is known as a spiral curriculum will mean that you will be revisiting topics with your classes and building on them over the course as students acquire wider mathematical knowledge. This sounds like a big change, but we'll provide you with resources to implement this, to help your students revise what they have learnt and to test their knowledge along the way to make sure they're retaining key concepts. The fifth change is to the assessment itself. More content means more hours in the exam room. We believe every student will need to sit at least 4.5 hours of exams, but this has not yet been finalised. Students will also need to memorise more formulae, as only a very few will be provided in the exam papers. Finally, the grading of exams will change. A star to G grades will disappear, and the new GCSE will be graded using numbers 1 up to 9, with 9 being the highest. Foundation tier will cover grades 1 to 5, and the higher tier will overlap, covering grades 4 to 9. So, overall, there's quite a lot of change for you to get used to, but we're sure that with time, you'll be quite familiar with the new GCSE. These 6 points give you a summary of the changes, but we've put more detail about this and our other maths qualifications on our website for you. In terms of how we can help you, there are 3 things to bear in mind. Number 1, we will provide you with a wide range of materials, tools, and resources to help you and your students make the transition. Number 2, we can provide you with face-to-face training. We hold events across the UK where we help teachers prepare and polish any new approaches to teaching. And number 3, you can sign up to our email update service to be sure you're up to date with the latest details, schedules, and resources. And finally, why choose OCR? We at OCR are deeply committed to developing a new maths GCSE that engages and challenges students in all the right ways. To do this, we're working in close partnership with schools, universities, and subject associations, as well as with employers. In fact, we've already run trials with 300 GCSE students to test new types of questions and innovative ways of bringing maths to life in the classroom. I believe that here at OCR, we have the experience and expertise to build a truly exciting, new and relevant maths GCSE that will give students the skills they need for future study, employment and for life. Together, we can get this right.